welcome to another episode of Weekend Out. My name is Gaurav. Now we all know that arts and crafts is very important for kids, right? It's a great way of developing spatial ability and creativity. Of course, not to mention that in the month of Ramadan, where you have a couple of extra hours as well, it's a great way to keep your kids busy too. But did you guys know that arts and crafts is equally important for adults as well? Now there are numerous studies that state that adults who engage in arts and crafts benefit in many ways, and two of the important ones are that one, they boost self-esteem. I had no clue about this, but they say this really helps your self-esteem. And the other one is that it also sort of delays the development of memory problems that happen with age. So basically what it does is you're enhancing your brain health. That's very important, and we want that to happen to you as well. So we're going to teach you a DIY technique. Now DIY of course stands for do it yourself. So this is something that we're going to teach you how to do yourself. It's a technique called decoupage, and it's very easy to learn. You need to have a few things. You need to have some paper cutouts, you need to have some tissue paper, and you need to have something that's recyclable. So probably a bottle, a can, a table, whatever. And now, if you concentrate for the next 5 minutes, you will find the creative side of yourself.
My name is Hitesh. I run an online store called Paper Curves. We supply all types of art and craft material like paper quilling, decoupage, scrapbooking and so on. We conduct workshops and we call them crafternoons because that's the time when you can nurture your creativity. And today we are having a decoupage workshop, and we are teaching them how to decorate the normal stuff that they have in the house, and they can paint and decoupage it. Today we are doing decoupage, and as you know, it is a process where we cover any surface with paint and then we'll put paper and glue it to the surface. So this is a planter which we are taking. It is in metal. You can do the same process with ceramic, with wood or any other surface. The procedure will be slightly different, but for wood and ceramic, it is the same process that we are doing. When you are doing decoupage on wood, you have to give one coat of chalk paint with brush. And once it's dry, you have to sand it with the sandpaper and do another coat of chalk paint with brush. It's very simple to do. You can do it with any paint you have. The best form of paint is to use chalk colors, which we are using today in the workshop. Apart from that, you can use any paper napkins with good motifs on it or specialized decoupage paper. When you want to use other colors, for example, over here I've used a lilac color. So I've used a classic decoupage paper. These are all translucent paper, approximately 40 to 60 GSM. So when you use a colored backdrop, the design will still show. Okay, so this is the difference. When you're using white surface, use rice paper and paper napkins. When you're using colored chalk paints, go for these easy peasy decoupage classic paper. Normally all the tissue papers, they are either 2-ply or 3-ply. So once you have cut, just remove the extra layers from it. Okay? So first layer comes off easily. The second layer will take little effort, and sometimes tissue paper just has 2 layers. See, like this. So all good quality tissue papers, they have 3 plies, okay? We had a lot of demand for decoupage workshops. Initially, people just wanted to learn a new craft, but as they learned and got interested in it, they started taking classes, making their own products and selling it on different platforms, and they've got very good response. So if you're interested in decoupage, do join us for one of our crafternoons. We are sure you are going to enjoy, learn something new. It's very simple to do, very cost effective, and you'll be able to do it yourself.